Navigation intern. Basically, my job is to communicate with the bridge, give them any instructions we need while we're mapping. If they have to slow speed or speed up or look out for something, we talk to them and they do that. We also watch the position of the ship on the monitors when dives are going on, so we make sure the ship is positioned where it needs to be to allow the ROVs to move and explore the things that they need to. And we also watch the return from the mapping sonar on the screen when we're mapping.
So I'm in charge of basically the communications between the bridge and the control van. And I use a software, predominantly HiPAC, where you could see what the ship's doing, what Argus is doing, what Herc's doing, and you kind of coordinate all those movements together and moving the ship and bridge communications and coordinating everything.
Hello, this is the bridge, and I would like to show you. When the ROVs are launching or recovering, we use that. And here we, the control van show us where is the waypoint, bearing, distance, and what they want to do. GPS, two GPS. The communication with the control van.
Clear and concise communications, that's important for the navigator's role. Maintaining the big picture of the goals for the mission, which involves communication with the chief scientist to see what you want to accomplish, and then time management to keep the dive on schedule to accomplish those goals.
So if we can move the launch site to somewhere a little bit closer to this canyon?
We can, and we can do that even while we are diving, because we have more than 1 hour.
Sure, we do have 1 hour.
And that's where the current pushed us.
Right,
so
we just let it
drift. Okay. So let's get the team ready. Captain already approved this, so.
I think probably the biggest challenge would fulfill the scientific mission with the actual navigation mission of getting from point A to point B. Research vessels move a lot different than regular boats. That's where you have to decide what place you should go, why you should go there, and the route that you may take may be a lot different and may have a lot more stops than like what I'm used to.
Once we completed the move, please let me know. Thank you very much.
Go ahead, bridge.
Step completed.
Okay.
As a good navigator, one of the things I try to teach my students, and I try not to forget myself, is to always assess the information. Say, okay, I have this piece of information. Does this really make sense? You know, it might be odd, but that might be because there's a current or something else going on, or it might be odd because I've either made a math error or I've entered a number wrong or whatever the factors. But just, you know, sort of going back through that assessment loop and saying, okay, here's this piece of information. Does it make sense? I like it because of the spatial aspect. One of the things I've learned teaching it is that with the piloting, it's really amusing to watch is that the artistic students who are sort of used to spatial aspects, they often get the piloting pretty quickly, working on a chart and talking about lines and bearings and all.
It's a really different culture from what we see in the military, so like everyone's on a first name basis. I just talked to someone and he emphasized, you know, although I'm just an intern coming here, it's like you're on the same level with everyone else. You can talk to them. They're training you to do their job. They're not having you run and get coffee or anything. Like you're actually learning to do what they do. And this is just a whole new experience to me. I'm trying to learn what questions to ask, where I need to go, what I'm not exactly told what I should be doing, just to maximize this experience. So it's really new and it's interesting.
Wasn't that really cool?